Hello and welcome to the Django DRF project, eCommerce. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials which you can watch for free. The link to the YouTube course playlist is in the video description. This course is also available on Udemy, where you can watch the course ad-free, download the tutorial source code, and access all updated tutorials and playlist. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Before we start developing any tests, let's familiarize ourselves with two types of testing which we're going to be utilizing within our project. There are two types of tests that we're going to be building at this initial stages of our project, and that's going to be the unit test and end-to-end test, commonly known as E2E. So what exactly is a unit? Well, a unit can be almost anything that you want it to be. It could be a line of code, it could be a function, it could be a method or a class. Generally, though, we want to make sure that the unit that we are testing is smaller. Generally, smaller is better. Let's apply this knowledge within our application to maybe get a better idea of what a unit test is. So in the previous tutorial, we went ahead and utilized coverage, and we scanned our application for potential tests that need to be created. And you can see here from the results, we had three missing tests within our model.py file. If you watched the tutorial, we then created a report with coverage and we took a look, and it informed us that the Dunderstring methods required testing. So in this scenario, this function here is our unit. Our goal is to test the functionality of this function to ensure that it behaves exactly how we intend it to. To ensure that we develop a unit test, we must try and make sure that we test this unit in isolation, which means that we don't want to try and run a test on this piece of code, and potentially this piece of code might be reliant on other code, other units, in order to work correctly. So in that case, it wouldn't necessarily be a unit test that we're developing. So as a unit test, what we're trying to do is we're trying to isolate this code away from the rest of our application and only test the specifics, the expected behavior, in this case, of this function. Now, this function may in fact require other resources. So to build this unit test, we would go through a process, for example, called mocking, which would be a process where we would gather all the data together that's required in order to actually run our unit test or to test this unit here. That would be an initial stage. And then we can go ahead and with that data or with that resource that we've mocked, we can then go ahead and just test this unit of code. So if that isn't resonating with you, just imagine we were to delete all of our code now, except for this function here. That's essentially what we're doing. We just simply want to test to make sure that this function works as intended. Now, if we deleted all the other code, well, we would need some sort of other information in order to actually effectively test this function. So mocking is that process where we gather the resources and information that's required in preparation then to run our unit test on this particular unit of code. So in comparison, an end-to-end test, this is testing the behavioral flow of the software. I guess that's kind of a fancy way of just saying that we are testing the entire software from start to end, along with any kind of interactions it may have with any other external interfaces or resources. So take, for example, in our application, we're building an API. We have already developed some endpoints where clients can then request data from our database through our API. So we have already conducted some testing in some respects, in that we utilize this user interface here to test our endpoint. So let's imagine we wanted to test our brand endpoint. We can use this button here, try it out. So what we're doing here is we're testing. What are we testing? Well, we're testing the API URLs to make sure that it matches the correct URL. We're testing, for example, the query to ensure that the query returns the correct data. That query is connected to a database. Now, we've already built all the models that are required in order to actually return data, as well as the serializer. So here, essentially, this could be considered maybe an end-to-end test because we are testing the software from end to end. we are testing the software from the start. This is simulating the client. We're sending a request from the client. That's going through the whole system all the way along until it gets to the end, which is, of course, back to the client here. So we're testing all of those systems inside of that request, inside of our system that is needed in order to perform this request. And you can see that we execute this and we return data from our database. So the comparison here between unit test and end-to-end testing. Unit testing, we are testing a very specific unit of code that may be performing an individual function. Typically, a unit test would just test one thing, one function. And in comparison, we have an end-to-end test, which is going to test a whole process from end to end, so from start to end, testing all of the interfaces and interactions which are required in order to actually undertake or fulfill a certain request or a certain task within our application.